I'm Ben Beegley and I go to St. Kevin's College in Toorak. My project is a bamboo bike, which is lightweight, organic and cheap and for most people to buy, and it is also rear suspension. I ride bikes quite a lot and I really wanted to get myself a rear suspension bike, but they're very, very expensive and I couldn't afford one. So instead I looked at some other materials instead of using metal, and bamboo was good for the suspension because it was flexible and really, really strong. So I decided to try and make it out of bamboo instead of metal.
I'm Conrad Shears, I go to Caulfield Grammar School. My project was about the effects of texting on the safety of driving, particularly hands-free texting. I thought I could objectively measure the effects of texting on the safety of driving, so I used a driving simulator and hands-free and hands-on texting applications.
My name is Angela Liao and I go to Lynham High School. My project looked at the possibilities of utilising different flavours of gum in increasing saliva flow and neutralising pH in the mouth. What inspired me to conduct this experiment was an advertisement I saw on TV for chewing gum. It talked about the plaque neutralisation properties of gum, so that got me interested. And so I thought, well, perhaps the flavour of chewing gum has an effect on this as well. And that's what really inspired me to do this experiment.
My name is Ethan Butson and my school is the Uluwara Grammar School. My science project was creating an augmented reality system that is able to aid in stroke management as well as with vision impairment. So what it's able to do is create a situation whereby the patient is kept in their real world, but then you change what they're seeing so that then the effect that's being applied to what they are actually visually seeing is able to help with their specific condition.
I'm McKinley Button and I am from the Illawarra Grammar School. My project was about the invention of the slow grow snail, which is a new device that you can put in your garden to deter snails from your seedlings. I found through my testing that the best barrier was a combination barrier of copper tape and a 5 centimetre water moat. Now this copper tape acts as a sort of electric fence, so it reacts with the snail's mucus to create a sort of electric shock, which they obviously wouldn't like. I've always loved working with animals, and although snails are quite gross, it was interesting to work and find out how the anatomy of a snail, that was quite interesting, figuring out what they use to find their way around their world.
I'm Jake Cobbinger from Gungahlin College. So my project was an intelligent glove which can recognise hand gestures to control just about anything that's connected to the internet. So to turn the light on, I would make a gesture with my glove, which would send a message to my Android phone, which would then send a message over the Wi-Fi to my web server on my computer. I think science is just a more formal way of describing curiosity for the things around us. And I think everyone's curious, but those who are interested in science, I think they want to find more, they're hungry for more.